number one in the world following their defeat to Ireland last week. But they've regrouped, refocused, and will be hoping to bounce back with victory against Fabrice Galtier's side this evening to round off their Northern Hemisphere tour. French side back in Paris after last weekend's victory over Georgia in Bordeaux, back in front of this expected sellout crowd of over 81,000. And isn't it looking spectacular? The phone lights on. We're going to be treated to a little bit of a light show over the course of the next couple of minutes. And, well, as you may see marked on the big screens, this is to signify 2 years to go until that Rugby World Cup taking place here in France in 2023. It's been a day, really, of World Cup simulation because, well, you may have taken in the England-South Africa game earlier. Of course, it was a rerun of that Rugby World Cup 2019 final. And tonight, France against New Zealand, well, it will be the opening match in September in 2023. Early chance for bragging rights, one could say. The two teams won't meet, in fact, after this evening's test until it is that opening game. Quite the atmosphere build here at the Stade de France. And we're expecting a couple of rather special guests to be joining us. Jerome Kano, world champion with New Zealand, and he's accompanied by, well, a Bond girl, no less, French actress Léa Seydoux. And what could be in that box? Good evening, Bill. The William Webb Ellis Cup, the Rugby World Cup. They're not shy of a bit of hype in France, it's fair to say. Ian Foster was asked this week about, well, whether this match has some significance given it'll be the opening game of 2023, but he mentioned that New Zealand got the beating of South Africa at the start of Rugby World Cup 2019 and then they went on to win it. Well, I dare say the French would take that in a couple of years' time. It's a typical November evening in Paris, 9 degrees with very little wind to speak of. We're hoping it should stay dry as well. This will be the 62nd meeting of these two. France managing a win about once in every five encounters, though you have to go back to Dunedin in 2009 for the last time France were victorious. And if you're talking home form, well, New Zealand have a record in France stretching back 14 games. 21 years they've had the measure of the home side. And as for the Stade de France, well, the All Blacks have never lost here. 6 wins and a draw. We've got plenty of fans in. Tricolours are plenty, cockerel hats, berets, scarves, face paint. A chance to witness a bit of history, perhaps, if Antoine Dupont and his side can impress this evening. We had a visit from President Emmanuel Macron this week. Also, the actor Jean Dujardin aimed to give them a bit of a boost. Not sure whether it's designed to calm the nerves or fire them up. But either way, here we go. Delighted to welcome former Scotland international Johnny Beattie into the Codecom seat, a man who spent many a year playing his club rugby in France. And Johnny, well, a wounded New Zealand side versus 1 foot on the beach. Will the loss last week have sharpened the senses?
Look, a wounded All Black side is a very dangerous All Black side, isn't it? Good evening, everybody. Yes, a loss for them last week, but for decades, the All Blacks have set the standard on the international scene. and it's been a rare sight to watch them lose, let alone back-to-back tests. That being said, they will have to up their game on both sides of the ball if they're to be victorious here tonight in Paris after a poor weekend in Dublin.
Well, for France, a win by 9 points against Argentina a fortnight ago here, a decent win against Georgia last week in Bordeaux, but probably a few too many errors in that game.
They've won their first two, but the manner wasn't exactly convincing. Nick, again, Ireland gave them the blueprint last weekend, and France need to combine their emotion and that raw power with superior detail in their attack and look after that ball as Ireland did. If they cough up possession and offer turnover ball to New Zealand tonight, it could be a long old evening.
Well, France playing last Sunday, they've had one less day of prep with a 6-day turnaround. Few will look to that come the full-time whistle, though. Preparation for this match has been a long time coming. Just one more match of the Autumn Nations series when Ireland play Argentina tomorrow, but this is the hottest ticket in town tonight. Just before we get to the anthems, a moment, of course, to remind everyone that racism isn't acceptable in rugby, in sport, or the world we live in, as if the message needs to be said again. Sadly, today, it does appear to be the case.
It's not acceptable in rugby, in sport, or the world we live in. Thank you for your support. Make sure
there are a healthy number of European-based Kiwis who will no doubt be well lubricated at this point, ready to sing with pride and gusto. The Marseillaise will follow. We'll see our first glimpse of Aaron Smith. But first, it's God Defend New Zealand.
Mesdames, Messieurs, merci s'il vous plaît de vous lever en l'honneur des hymnes nationaux. Et tout d'abord, l'hymne de la Nouvelle-Zélande.
Dear fans, please stand up for the national anthems. We start with the national anthem of New Zealand.
Mesdames, Messieurs,
en l'honneur de l'équipe de France. La Marseillaise.
Ladies and gentlemen, in honor of l'équipe de France, la Marseillaise.
A single hair on my body that is not stood on end. What a rendition of La Marseillaise. Now, two sides are just going to switch here. And you may notice that the famous All Blacks are not in all black. It is, of course, their away strip. Over the past few weeks, lacks of Ireland, Italy and Wales have had the cultural challenge delivered to them, each choosing to respect and respond to it in their own way. Well, here comes the hacker in front of the French public at the Stade de France. Delivered. Let's have a look at the teams then. Fabien Galthié makes five changes from France's win against Georgia. Hooker Marchand out to start for Peter Movaca, who's running at three tries in two games. Krol comes in for the injured Makalu, with Willemsen getting the nod alongside Cameron Wauquiez. In the backs, it's an all-Bordeaux halfback pairing as the Jali Tamak experiment is put on pause. And Tamak starting at fly half this afternoon, a selection no doubt made to allow Jonathan Danti into the midfield alongside his former clubmate, Gael Ficou. For New Zealand, well, Ian Foster makes seven changes as he talked this week about needing to refresh the focus after the loss to Ireland. Three changes in the pack. See Coles, Ioane and Sam Kane come back, bringing with them 167 caps worth of experience. In the backs, having arrived just over a week ago, it's Aaron Smith, who surprised a few by being handed the start alongside Richie Mwanga after Beauden Barrett failed to sufficiently recover from a head knock last week. Quintu Paya earns his seventh cap in the centre. Galthié sticking with a 6-2 split on the bench, with just Luku and Jalibert covering the back line. Damien McKenzie is eyeing up a 40th All Blacks cap. Well, Johnny Beattie, the key men this evening.
Look, I think the French Republic has had a big, fat, juicy cross next this fixture since it was announced. This is their litmus test. They are looking forward to seeing Antoine Dupont against Aaron Smith. Undoubtedly, Greg Aldrit up against Ardi Savea. They want to see how they stand and how the next years is going to look before that big opening fixture of the World Cup for these two sides. Massive collisions, massive head-to-heads and a huge game of rugby.
Well, Wayne Barnes is the man in the middle, assisted by Luke Pearce and Carl Dixon. Our TMO is Stuart Terridge. It's Wayne Barnes' first test since France against Scotland in March. His fourth time taking charge of France against New Zealand, including a certain match in 2007 in a World Cup quarter-final, where France overcame the All Blacks. Saturday night in Paris. Can France take a few pages out of Ireland's book last week? Ian Foster's All Blacks admitting they started the week hurting, sulking. This is their last meeting before that World Cup opener in September 2023. It's Melvin Jaminet. He's looking to return and tiptoe his way through the New Zealand pack. First carry for Cyril Bay. Coming around the corner. Anthony Gillon wanted to get his hands on it, but it's turnover ball for New Zealand on their own 10-metre line. Smith looking to the right and to the left. Ian Foster talking too much about how he wants Smith's control, his composure, something he thought was missing in Dublin a week ago. Tomac's come forward to claim it. He's done well enough for it to bounce and be picked up by Antonio. And now France have penalty advantage, which Dupont will no doubt want to use. And Tomac coming forwards, ball back inside for his scrum half. They work in tandem together so well, the Toulouse halfbacks. It's an away from Gillon. Stade de France volume's gone up. Gillon again to the left. Little chip through from Danty. Will come to nothing. And I wonder if France thought they might have had a penalty advantage. Perhaps New Zealand thought it was going to come back for that as well, because it's been, well, fly hacked sideways into touch, Johnny.
Oh, what an opener for France. The long break coming from Roman Antomac, short
there,
in defence on the blind side.
Again, just support that body work a bit better, sir.
Nice early line break, takes the ball to line, the inside ball to Dupont, who keeps the ball alive.
Restez 10. Restez 10.
Again, he asked the questions, we thought the advantage was coming. I think Barrett as well thought the ball was going to be pulled back, but what an opportunity now for France. 5 minutes from the All Blacks line.
Mouvaka looking for his option, Woki. And Makalu were the main men last week. It's going to be working in the absence of Makalu. And it's back with Mouvaka. He got a couple of tries on the board last week through the rolling ball. Can they get any more change out of this All Blacks pack as Antoine Dupont is given one warning to use it? Now a penalty advantage, and it's down on the line, and France have the try. Mouvaka smuggling it over. Any suggestion of a bit of mishandling as that went down, Johnny?
Possibly, but what a start for France. Again, earning themselves the right to play. Wonderful taken there by Cameron Walkie. What an image. And even the All Blacks, once that maul is set up, once it's formed, so hard to stop. Peto Mouvaka just sneaking over.
Thanks very much. Good work, everyone.
Absolutely crucial for France. They had to start this game well and get ahead from the get-go. And they've done so.
Great work on that forward.
Smuggled under the arm, just over the line. Wayne Barnes well positioned. And this to turn 5-7. Jaminet adding the extras. France leading by 7-0 inside 4 minutes at the Stade de France.
Quite incredible. And again, take on the All Blacks. You have to take them on up front. So good in tight play, that tight five, one of the best in the world. And what a start for France. The crowd absolutely loving the start to this game.
And Mouvaka up to 4 tries in 3 games now. Does such a good job of latching himself onto the back of those catch and drive moves.
Dupont.
New Zealand running forwards. We don't have Beauden Barrett, but we do have brother Geordie. Said that the body wasn't feeling too hot Sunday to Wednesday, but started to feel a little more normal. It's Smith looking to the right. Brodie Retallick.
How you come?
French crowd cheering every hit that the boys in blue can make. Whitelock captaining the side, the Crusaders' second row on his 132nd cap. Allez les Bleus rings around. Penalty goes to New Zealand.
And then back on it, goes straight on the ball.
Getting themselves beyond the ball and trying to secure it. It was Gabin Villiers who was the man singled out by Wayne Barnes.
Sorry, Matt, I just didn't see it.
It's going to be such a crucial area for both sides. Tonight, again, the physicality, the breakdown, two areas. Plums, John Plumtree, identified before this game. They have to get better if they're going to be in it. And Dean Coles, such an evasive, dynamic winner. Winger, hooker, pardon
yeah,
me.
Yeah, there you are, thanks, mate.
Again, managed to get the ball away. Gabin Villiers
keep
just pinged.
Keep that timing on those kickoffs. That was great, thank you. I presume you're going to tell me when the player's put on tonight, aren't you?
Jordy Barrett has been given the kicking duties. Richie Mwanga could have been one in the lineup. Said he wasn't sure midweek, Barrett, who might get the tap on the shoulder to be the goal kicker, but he will get to continue. Got 10 points against Ireland last week. And this for New Zealand's first points of the evening. Judged to perfection. France 7, New Zealand 3. Supporters already in good spirits.
That's
what you get when a game kicks off at 9 in the evening. Romain Antemac. 18th start for France. Been taken by George Bridge. The starts against the USA and Italy on their Northern Hemisphere tour. Smith with the box kick clearance. Jaminet.
Sam, just time that run.
The line out to be taken in its own
good,
time.
Yeah. On you again, Joe, thanks.
Again by Bridge, we just see that line chase.
Yeah, please, the
speed of Fiku, so good defensively as well, such an aggressive tackler.
Aaron Smith, first test in 3 months. Last feature for the All Blacks against Australia at Eden Park in mid-August. Line-out throw is heavy, goes over the top, and it's going to be claimed by Dane Coles. And then the support line from Surveyor was strong. Wasn't held in the tackle as well, so he's made some really key yards as Mwaka tries to hold him up. But it's still with New Zealand. It's the young man, Tupaia, getting the ball from Mwanga. First real spell of New Zealand with ball in hand. Tupaia looking to offer himself once more.
Advantage offside, Aaron.
Penalty advantage is being played. Ritalik then out to Tupaia. Damien Penaud had shut down the passing option for New Zealand to make any more yards down the short side. Gone against Mwaka. Aaron Smith given the penalty advantage call. Now will this be another shot and another 3 points? The ball goes into the hands of Jordy Barrett. That's exactly what it will be.
Just, did we get
undone by this loose throw. You can see actually the All Blacks stacking the contest, leaving the front completely, making that contest extremely hard. But again, once you get these guys in broken field, once you give Ardie Savea front football, you see what a good carrier he is. Front football is so hard to defend. You can see France rushing up, almost blitzing, Sean Edwards style, just creeping offside. And again, shot at three for Jordy Barrett.
No problem from that sort of range. Doubling the All Blacks tally. Cut the deficit down to one, France 7, New Zealand 6. That French discipline, they will be hoping, is not going to be a key part of the contest. Then Tamak. Penaud is putting the chase on, but Bridge is going to take that one. It was a little deeper, a little easier for him, much more time. Smith.
And use it!
Sam came down the short side, but Smith is taking his own sweet time, wanting to maintain his own tempo. in the face of a team that like to play quick. It's well taken by Jaminet. Wookie from Dupont. Halfway line, central position. Ball popped away for Cyril Bai. Toulouse prop. Brilliantly shrugged away from Dupont. A moment ago, he was in a battle to bring Surveyor to ground. That time, he tunnels underneath him.
And let go, please! Oh, you're placing it into him. Place it away from him.
Okay. Barnes has been around the block a few times. He's not going to buy too many penalty suggestions from France as they push the ball into All Blacks players on the ground. But now Entomat will go aerial. He wants this coming down just outside the 22. It's George Bridge inside the 22. And he's got all the experience to call the mark. Looks to try and get as much distance as he can on that. Entomac is there with Jaminet to his right, and he's going to play away to his fullback. Jaminet cutting back infield. Pono trying to get there and help support his fellow back three man. Antonio looking to try and bounce through Brody Retallick. And Dupont will play again. And Tamak with a bit more depth to Dante. Dante Fiku outside. Pano inside. And Pano manages to straighten. And Pano towards the 22. All the work to do on his own as his teammates rush to try and support him. Dupont picked up from the ruck. France having to work really hard to try and reactivate that front foot momentum. But Pano brought them right up to the All Blacks 22. Dupont looking to the left, Woki snatches it away, having had it popped up. France just losing their shape a little bit, but Fiku wants to take up the cudgels. Off to the right once more, the carry from Willemsen. Big man in the second row, and arriving late is Villiers. The New Zealand are calling players down to this side. Antonio will be the dummy runner, and Tamak will cut inside and score! His last try was against Ireland over a year ago, but Entomac is scoring against the All Blacks.
And what a phase of play for France. Time after time, Antoine Dupont keeping the ball alive, taking on that physical challenge on the gain line and getting change over the gain line, so hard to stop. And what a finish by Roman Entomac.
I've given a try, Sam.
Sam Whitelock is remonstrating with Wayne Barnes, but
they're asking about a pass, but I'm all happy, I'm all in.
There was a moment after Pano's initial run where it just looked like it might be dying, didn't it? But France did so well to reinvigorate the attack.
They did, and from nothing really again. Standstill play, Cyril Bai taking on the gain line. Emotion, raw power, physicality. And then the quality out the back. Roman Entomac, a step off the right. And they'll be absolutely delighted as a coaching team. Fabien Galthié, one of the world's best attack coaches, and what a start for them. Unbelievable stuff.
Jaminet. Two tries on the board for France, two conversions on the board for Jaminet. Another look at the try. France leading 14 points to 6. Richie Mwanga, Crusaders fly half, got 59 minutes last week in Dublin. Taken by Aldrit. Dupont. Keeps it short and sweet.
As opening exchanges go, watching attacking rugby, we're used to seeing defences get on top, but what a change this has been, a breath of fresh air.
New Zealand's chance to try and come straight up the middle from the line out.
See it on the neck.
Into second phase for Surveyor. Was the 70th All Black captain when handed the duty, but the ball's gone forwards. And France have got turnover possession here, so used to saying that relative to All Black numbers. Dante has opted to send it downfield. Taken by Bridge for Barrett now.
Winger good.
France have the field pretty well covered, so Barrett just sends it as long as he can for Jaminet.
Wait!
Moanga. Barrett will take it from him. A bit more room on the right for Jordan, perhaps, who bounces through one tackle and comes away again. And Jordan has Smith on the inside. Position Aaron Smith is so often on the shoulder of attacking momentum. And now numbers over to the right for New Zealand. France having to come across and try and gather it. Rico Ioane loses his footing. Dante stops him 5 metres from the line. Aldrich trying to put pressure on and through. Smith looks to go with more depth. Moanga. Barrett thinks about the crossfield kick. It's loose. It's going to find Bridge. Oh. Bouncing his way through Pono. And into touch. Well, well, well.
Bouncing his way through Pono, but not through Fiku. Again, the defensive leader who's been so impressed over the past few weekends. We see the initial line break here. Aaron Smith, typical trailer line on the inside.
Yeah, watch his stop, mate, of course.
It was the initial break from Will Jordan as well, wasn't it? Nominated for World Rugby Breakthrough Player of the Year with Andrew Kellaway, Lewis Rees-Zammit, and Marcus Smith, who was on the winning side earlier.
Kick chases.
It was good, strong stuff from George Bridge.
Forwards are doing well, but they've got to work to come.
And shoveled out.
Yeah, but remember, if anyone's advancing, they're offside.
Another positive for France, breaking. Not completely broken, managing to scramble. Sean Edwards will be happy with that. Another facet of the French game that's come on leaps and bounds over the past few years, especially under his stewardship.
Nipa Laulala has taken a bit of attention, as is Aldrit. Cameron Wookie, Bordeaux Burglar, second row, just 22. Starting in the second row again this week. Good option for them there.
It is, but a pressure area up against Sam Whitelock, Brody Retallick, two men. Incredible amounts of experience, especially in this area. Line out time.
Movaka certainly taking his time. It wasn't the strongest area last week against Georgia. But that was tidier. And DuPont, he's got his dancing shoes on and he's only a few metres from his line. And in fact, the call has come through to Wayne Barnes. Someone playing the inside arm.
Came against Sam Whitelock. The contact. Contact in the air. The contest looked good in the first instance, but pulling down. Cameron Walkie's arm in the air. You cannot do that line out time.
It's all related to the safety of the players in the air. George Bridge has had an attempt to keep that in and he hasn't.
Just might be a little bit harsh. To be honest, there wasn't too much contact, if any.
Great, thanks, fellas.
Again, Antoine Dupont, the footwork. Unstructured play, wasn't going to plan, man, just to get himself out of trouble. Joy to watch.
Two teams are competing, incidentally, for the Dave Gallagher Trophy. The All Blacks have held since 2009. Down from Willemse, Dupont and Tamak. Aldrit arriving past the tail of the line-out from deep with pace. Antonio, real linchpin of focusing those rucks and allowing Dupont to play away from them. And this time it's going to be Gillon. And another pick from the open side. New Zealand coming through as Kane tries to put the pressure on. Aldrit once more. France happy to just take metre by metre at this stage in the middle.
And let go! Don't go on the side!
Solid effort defensively from Sam Whitelock, who made 20 tackles last week. And then it's Dante coming through, and Tamak off the right foot rides the tackle to ground. Fiku popping up at first receiver outside Dupont now. Dante back in the line. France backs like to cut against the grain and see what else is on, and Tamak is back in the pocket.
Wait, stop!
He'll kick many prettier drop goals than that. New Zealand with Barrett sends a chance to strike. Nobody all the way back, but Jaminé wastes no time in calling for the mark, just to give his team a breather more than anything else.
France setting their stall out in attack. Not so much structure, but just blood and guts, taking the ball up the middle, pick and go, challenging this All Blacks defensive line, having a go.
It's been a long old year. Long old Northern Hemisphere tour for New Zealand as well. Played five games in a row earlier in the year and then another five in a row now.
There's not many men that can sit down Brodie Retallick. Jonathan Dante again. I think career resurgence at La Rochelle this season. Brought back into the side by Fabien Galthié at 12. Incredibly physical.
Whitelock brings it down. Wayne Barnes doing the commentary for us. It was a good contest. It's back with Dane Coles. Off the bench last week for Cody Taylor. Gets a start this week. Smith looking to use Moanga. Is a little deeper. Ball's going to go up in the air for Tupaia to chase.
Good contest. Back off blue.
Back
off blue.
Off Villiers. France have it. Dupont.
At it.
Jaminet popping up to make the long range clearance. Moanga wants Barrett to run with him. Wants to try and unpick a hole in the French defensive line, but he's not found one there. Smith back for Jordi Barrett. That's gone plenty high enough. It's not taken too many yards
back
forward.
And
referee Barnes saying it went back off blue, but it's come back on the All Blacks side through Smith, Moanga, Barrett. Looking at the crossfield effort for Bridge. Oh, he'd done the hard work. And then he just could not onto it. Thumps the ground in frustration, and as well he might.
En avant.
First scrum.
Damien Penaud is rather relieved.
Absolutely, what may have been wasn't too much on.
Okay,
again, the search for space in international rugby, very inventive.
Scrum blue.
Again, the hard work was done. Just couldn't keep it in his hands.
But no guilty of the old. If you get the tackle, it looks wonderful. If you miss, not so much.
Simple play, no one. We're going.
Let's go. Get three in.
Trying to find solutions.
The Premier MLA, first scrum.
French defensive line.
Let's go.
Damien Penaud, Gael Ficou rushing up, cutting down time and space, forcing the ABs into different options.
A bit closer, please. A little bit closer.
We've had a quarter of the game played.
Yeah, stay there, please.
And Wayne Barnes has just reminded us all this is the first scrum. France shading it in terms of pack weight.
Balance at every stage. Balance to la phase.
A couple of significant caps in that All Blacks front row. Dane Cole's 80th test. Nipo Lala's 40th. Ardy Sarvea at the
Bind.
Back. Earning his 60th. A few small milestones.
Keep high,
it's in from Dupont. It's there with Aldrit. The pressure coming through from the All Blacks. And Aldrit opting to break with the backing of his captain.
He's done very well there, Greg Aldrit. Retreating scrum really under real pressure.
And use it, Jules.
Dupont. It's coming down for Bridge. Barrett chatting in his left ear. Puts it up in the air and Tanaka's underneath it. So is Jaminet. It's going to be the fly half who takes it. Looks to try and drill it low down the middle. He's the only one really chasing forward as well to put the pressure on Barrett. Barrett from outside is 22, has absolutely walloped it. And what you would probably call an unforced error. There was a slight groan from the Stade de France when the kick went from Antamak, but now they'll be delighted.
Jordi Barrett, I think, caught in two minds. Just treading outside of his 22, he didn't need to, he had time, he had space. Again, the execution completely let him down, uncharacteristic from Jordi Barrett. France given now another chance to launch. We saw how dangerous they were last week. Given a set piece that functions, given the ability to use decoy runners, make it difficult for the defensive opposition to set.
Lineup's untidy again from France. Wayne Barnes is just going to have a word.
No, Dan, hit the cameraman. Hit the cameraman.
Oh, let's just have a little
amateur hour from the cameraman.
It's wonderful that we get these close pictures, but we don't need them to be that close all of the time, do we?
Too close.
I'm just glad it was a French cameraman.
Lovely. The French not helping the French. Right, let's try that again, shall we?
Let's go, let's go.
Stop. still not the tidiest as New Zealand do a brilliant job of putting the pressure on and winning the ball back. But no, penalty France. They got themselves in a good position to get over and win the ball back. And Messrs Carl Dixon and Wayne Barnes are members of the You're Not Coming In club.
No more.
As they send the French away. They don't want them getting involved in any of that business. Penalty has been awarded. France can build from here.
I'll come and find you
not
in a second.
Small win.
I promise
France.
I'll come really and find you at the next stoppage.
Some contest again in the air by Brody Retallick. Once that ball goes loose,
it's just a contest in the air. They both get a hand to the ball.
Anthony Jalon, who's been so good again all season for Toulouse and for France, so physical. Two or three massive collisions already in this game. Contest there. Wins the ball back for France after a lost line-out. Another big moment for France.
For anyone wondering, Anthony Jalon. I thought Jalonge, but a man next to me knows. He says Jalon himself.
Well, he's an ex-teammate of mine from Cast. And he made me look really, really silly in pre-season. One of the best athletes I've come across. He was in the academy, so he didn't say anything to us for the first two seasons. But then,
as is the way,
as he grew into one of the best world, one of the best back rowers in the world, he said, "Look, France, actually, it's Geelong. Don't pronounce the CH."
There we go. Now we all know. So, a sing-song ahead of Jaminet. Jaminet looking to get France to 17. Villiers is chasing it in case he needs to, but he doesn't. It's a really good effort from Jaminet. Takes his personal tally to 7. France leading 17-16. Aldrit. Dupont. Wilkie was offering himself, but Mouvaka sensed a chance to pick and go.
Adet!
Barrett has Mwanga inside. Bridge to the left, as is Tupaia. Bridge cutting back down the centre. Running into the tackle of Jalon. Mwanga wanting to use the feet, but eventually reeled in by Francois Croix. And it's loose, Dancy plays it away, Ficou, little chip through with the right hand, and Jaminet is heading after this, Melvin Jaminet, unable to truly control it. Little conversation with Luke Pearce to check who it came forwards from. What a foot race.
What a foot race, but again, New Zealand looking lost in attack, chucking the ball backwards and forwards, lacking direction, France smothering them indeed. Another quality collision by Jalon, scrags him down, Ficou lifts his head up, nobody home. What a chase, Jaminet showing his wheels. Crowd letting us know what they think of that. Was that foul play by Rico Ayani?
Let's just say there are quite a few opinionated Frenchmen gesticulating to the screens at this moment.
He hasn't knocked the ball out of play, so to my mind, nothing foul about it. You can do what you want. You can't throw the ball into touch.
He's just tried to deny him having any control, and if the ball's gone backwards, no offence. But hey, those aren't the rules of French rugby pantomime on a Saturday night in Paris. The crowd know their role in this evening's events. They're on their feet in this corner. Oh, but they're not going to have too much to cheer as the French pack get a little overexcited, trying to engage too early. New Zealand will have the free kick, and Geordie Barrett will send this away. Back in their seats they go. Jaminet, the speedster.
8 is fine.
Puts it in the air. Great chase here from Ficou and from Aldrit. But it's a brilliant take from Richie Mwanga. Under so much pressure.
There you go, mate.
But the Crusaders man has done superbly well.
Interesting options as well. All Blacks looking to keep the ball on the field with that free kick. But a again, France just using kick chase, sticking the ball in the air. Something we're not used to seeing 10 years ago. They would have just run it back. But again, changes in strategy, changes in coaches.
Nice cap. Thanks, Ellis.
They've evolved and they have really pressurised this All Blacks team in the first 25 minutes of this game.
So many lead players in the story so far. We approach the half-hour mark. Mouvaka, England's opening try scorer, straight down off the top for Dupont and Tamak. Danti to bounce through the middle. He sent Mwanga back a metre or two. Now Fiku, oh, just held it up nicely out the back for Ntamack, but it was well read by Tupaya. Got around the corner and made the hit. France haven't really crossed the gain line from the line out, despite having possession and sending it through the hands. Dupont, no doubt, look aerially here.
Angela!
We can see what Jonathan Danti brings to the game. Jali Tamak experiment over. Physicality of Jonathan Danti taking that gain line, providing platform for his side.
Pernod with the follow-up tackle. Oh, and then the error. You don't often see that from Nipa Laulala. Turnover ball for France. Dupont has gone cross-field. Fiku tapped back inside for Ntamack. Up to the 22, out to the left. Is there going to be a chance for Villiers in the corner? Dupont will go digging. The French backline want it. San Kane puts the pressure on. Dupont thinks he might have seen a chance to score himself, but Retallick repels him. Villiers, one of the smallest men on the park, shoves it back through the legs, and then Aldrit, his number eight, carries it on. They thought there was a chance to grab it to the try line. Dupont has Antonio waiting.
Knock on there, no problem.
There was a little knock on the floor. We come back for the advantage that was being played. But France are loving every minute of this.
Sortier, ici.
And you can see the body language of these All Blacks. They look a little bit shell-shocked. Nothing's quite going right. They need to steady themselves, reset.
Decision, Antoine.
Because every time they touch the ball, unforced error, lifts his head up, watches the defense in front of them. And again, France so dangerous from turnover ball. The intelligence by Antoine Dupont lifts his head up. What a layoff by Gael Ficou. And another try-scoring opportunity presents itself to these French men. Scramble D from the All Blacks. And again, another 5 metre line out to defend. Does not get easier.
Gabin Villiers sitting down. Will Jordan will be a moment I'll enjoy reflecting on. France to build again through Cameron Walkie. Brings it down. It's with Mouvaka. There tends to only be one result. Oh. Mouvaka breaks and scores. Tries in three games for the French hooker, and he's done it again.
Yeah, but let's not let go, Lawrence. Keep working on that breakdown, work on those offside lines. That's the key. I've got the ball.
And another monstrous effort by this French back again. A lovely take once that ball is down. Big man, well organised. It's so hard to stop. Taken there by Walkie. Once that shears around the edge, Pito Mouvaka senses the moment to splinter off. And you can see again the body language of Dane Coles. Everything going in the French direction. What a moment for this French side. And this French pack. Bewilderment for the New Zealand coaching staff.
It was a right hold arm wrestle last week in Dublin. Ireland doing everything they could to frustrate, strangle, overpower New Zealand. And at the minute, well, France are running riot. It's another two.
Ireland ran riot last week, but in a completely different manner. It was controlled possession. It was meticulous. And dominant in different ways. This is just aggression, power, and desire.
absolutely.
Back off Black.
Back for Surveyor, but look at the work from Fiku to try and win it back. And then Dante sends it down. There's no one there. Bridge is having to track back. Penaud shoves Malunga out of the way and manages to make the hit on Bridge. And listen to the Stade de France as the blue shirts swarm around the All Blacks. Surveyor carrying it. It's good from Surveyor. It's the settled approach that was needed. Sam Kane adds his weight as Aaron Smith looks to clear and try and settle things for the visitors.
And it's a horrible cliche, something I hated my coaches telling me, but it just looks like France wants it more at the minute. Every collision, every 50-50, every ruck, there are five Frenchmen there before a white jersey gets there. But again, internally, this All Black side, they have to find solutions. It can't just be a question of desire. They are better than that. But at the moment, 20 points between the two sides, unbelievable stuff.
Rafael Ibanez there, just nervously clacking his hands together, almost in disbelief at what he's seeing. Comes through Sam Kane and Mwanga. Oh, it's the lovely feet of Rico Ioane, just straightening. Haven't seen too much of the All Black centre pairing of Tupaia and Ioane with ball in hand. Smith under a ton of pressure. They're losing yards in possession here, the All Blacks, and it's the French captain, Dupont, who wraps up Barrett. Mwanga through Bridge, out to Surveyor. Got it from Akira Ioane. Been used off the bench against Australia, Wales and Ireland. Penalty New Zealand.
Ojour, thank you.
Penalty goes against Paul Willemse, caught offside. Was selected with Cameron Wokey for much of the Six Nations in 2020, the Montpellier second row.
Another 10 metre line.
Of course, it's worth remembering that there is no Charles Olivon. Merci. He's been the French captain, of course. Turn to that back row. Jalon has played the likes of 6 and 7 and 8 as they've moved things around over the last few weeks.
Beyond 15.
New Zealand off the tail. Through Smith. And once again through Mwanga to find Ioane. Whitelock. Smith looking to the left. Dane Coles was the dummy runner. It's good yards from Brody Retallick. You won't get any panic from the All Blacks, despite the huge pressure that France are putting on them. Jordi Barrett, quick skip, and gets the head down. It's a good double hit. Francois Croix in there.
It is advantage. Smith again. He is in the way. Penalty advantage.
There's a penalty advantage now being played for an obstruction.
Penalty advantage, Aaron.
Smith for Laulala. Dummy runner, Mwanga. Tupaia was well downed. Made his debut at inside centre against Tonga in July, in for the injured Lena Brown, who he plays alongside. Mwanga, Smith again, comes back to this side. Akira Ioane was well driven back, and the home fans like that. Wayne Barnes has said, that'll do, we'll go back for the penalty.
And you can see the repeated defensive effort and line speed by France. Blitzing up, we've seen Antoine Dupont, we've seen Fiku forcing New Zealand to come back inside and play tight, and they're just not finding the solutions.
Coming your way.
Between Mwanga, between Aaron Smith. They're going to have to find solutions for getting outside and through this French defence, because at the minute they're being forced back inside and blitzed in big collisions. It's just not working for them.
60-40 territory in favour of France. Yeah. And perhaps a sign of where New Zealand sense they're at. Trailing, of course, 24 points to 6 with a penalty. 2 minutes to go until half-time. They decided not to chip away at that deficit, but to go for more. Dane Coles signed a new deal with the Hurricanes in April. It's Kane, back to Coles, tiptoeing up the touchline. Coles gets the ball away, but it was knocked forwards from Retallick. They nearly had France, but just the handling error.
Again, the 50-50, the wraparound.
down the 5 metre channel. Dane Coles, great scramble D again. It was Damian Penno. I thought it was just a missed pass, but again the hustle, the hurry from France, the hunger they've shown, snuffs out another Kiwi opportunity.
Okay, Melee.
Dane Coles spoke during the week on the suggestion that following a long tour, perhaps their eyes are on the end, their eyes are on a holiday, on the beach. Well, Dane Coles was pretty categoric. He said he wants to be able to lie on that sand without a bump under his towel, metaphorically speaking. There's already one in the shape of Ireland underneath it. They do not want to go back-to-back defeats in Europe.
Balance! Crouch! Bind! Set!
Seen some pressure coming through the French scrum. Aaron Smith is appealing loudly to Wayne Barnes.
Hold on. Okay. Start again.
Really well. Start.
All of his 101 caps.
Yeah, it's just a little bit kind of delayed. Let's try it again. Okay.
We saw Aldrick have to play it away fairly quickly.
Melee. Okay. Nice high bind.
Previous scrum.
Antoine. Avec s'il vous plaît.
Oui, merci.
Into Papaliti.
Yeah, just come off.
Made 30 tackles against Ireland. Papaliti.
Antoine Desport-Lavalant. Wait for the ball.
42 in the Autumn Nations series, more than any other player.
Okay, when you're ready.
But it's great to see Sam Kane back. His third test after 6 months out. He's been allowed the game time thanks to Papaliti's great form. Not taking charge of captaincy duties today, but was given that role 18 months ago. Clock has ticked into the red. Dupont, Aldrich, well, he will do the duty to clear it into touch. And Wayne Barnes will end the first 40. The Stade de France is rising to its feet to applaud the French team off the field after that first half effort. They're enraptured with their side, and so they should be. Three tries, two from the hooker Mouvaka, and Ntamack with a sweet one as well. Two penalties from the boot of Jordi Barrett means at half time. Their way out onto the field as the second half gets underway. Three tries to nil. Les Bleus have on the board in the first half. And it's got to be a case, Johnny Beattie, of more of the same.
Absolutely, it's how much they can keep it going. The defensive pressure, I've rarely seen an All Black side under pressure like that for 40 minutes in a first half of rugby. Can they maintain the repeated effort, the defensive sets they're going through, the turnovers they're creating, the chaos they're generating? And keep leaning on this crowd. The emotion generated in this place in the first half was exceptional. Can they do it again?
Real 16th man territory stuff. Definite signs of Sean Edwards' influence in the hunger, their willingness to keep working for each other, even if things didn't work, go again.
Again, the tired cliches of French being lazy, and absolutely not. The repeated work, the repeated defensive sets, the aggression and the organisation that we haven't seen before. With Fabien Galthié and Sean Edwards, top-class coaches.
Wayne Barnes was very quick to call the ball out there once Dupont had picked it up. And that was loose. And New Zealand get their hands on it.
Off feet. Restails.
France go off their feet to try and secure it. Initially, it was Dupont who was harried and hassled at the base of the ruck. Now the advantage isn't coming. And this will be just the start to the second half that New Zealand will have wanted. Penalty towards the end of the first half. They opted to kick into the corner.
That's great, just asking that question, Dane. If you ask, I'll answer and you can go around there. Perfect.
It's going to be more of the same.
Pretty much the only shot they got to fire in that first half. It was lost forward down the 5 metre channel. Will they maul this time? Will they keep it tighter and keep the ball in hand?
Don't come early, fellas.
Yeah, certainly look to play around the front of the line out.
Aaron,
just before half time. Where will this go?
They'll go to Ioane. And now they look to try and engage some more momentum. France counter drive. It's a really good bit of work from France, and they put the pressure on. Tupaia thought he might have spotted a route right through. 9 metres out, France get themselves the penalty. And it's the hard work of Gregory Aldrit.
Double move, but tackle then propelled himself forward.
But again, the grit shown by France to repel that maul. So hard to launch from off the back. Again, you could see the attempted strike play. New Zealand looked all at sea again. Sixes and sevens, no real dynamism to the attacking play off the back of that maul. All ends up a little bit scrappy. Another turnover for France.
It's Francois Croix with the key intervention.
In this defensive effort, Paul Willemse, Cameron Wauke, Cyril Bai. Massive men. Again, the second bite, the second movement. You cannot gain that extra meter anymore, that's illegal. It's a real chance for New Zealand to get back into this game.
Marseillaise ringing around the Stade de France. France's last home win against New Zealand in 2000.
Yeah, he's gone back.
They have to go back a lot further for a win in Paris against the All Blacks. Plenty of time left, of course. And New Zealand are the sort of team that can eat up a scoreboard in no time at all.
Seven who?
Okay. Smith. For Kane.
OK, back we come. Thrown across, number four. Back we go.
Referee Wayne Barnes has signalled an error at the line. Thanks. Out.
Four across the line. Thanks, Zero.
It's against Brodie Retallick.
There's two. Merci. Merci.
Cyril
across
Bai,
the line.
Helping tuck in the microphone pack and equipment.
The error is just compounding for New Zealand.
Jaminet has gone for even more on that.
Play on.
Jordy Barrett has managed to keep it in field. Denying them.
Christophe, I need a belt.
A line out right on the line. Played back in from France this time. There's Jaminet. Sends it aerially. Competition for it was great. Brilliantly won.
Wait, stop. Yep.
Has that just bounced and gone out? Oh, that's very nicely done from Jordan.
A belt. I was going to say Paolo Nome en français.
A belt. First glance, like it had gone out in the full. There's the line.
Wonder what he's making of what he sees.
I think he'll have loved that first half.
So kick from inside their own half, landed.
Certainly a first half to remember. Can France keep it up and make it a match to remember? Good platform now for New Zealand. It's Retallick, Kane, Crowe wrapping up his man. Toulouse flanker doing a good job of putting himself about. Lalala places it back. Akira Ioane swatting away Cameron Wauke, and that's no mean feat. Then the pick around the fringe comes Surveyor. Big game player. Face the likes of Ireland and Wales, South Africa. New Zealand, Argentina, penalty advantage being played, and Dane Coles with the pick smuggles it into the hands of Retallick.
It's a penalty advantage, Aaron, penalty advantage. If you latch your...
Aaron Smith has been given the penalty advantage call. Rico Ioane is looking,
it is a penalty,
wanting it
advantage
to the right, but now he's just taken up a position back to the left of Smith.
If you pre-bind, don't go off your feet.
Communication is strong from Barnes to ensure that New Zealand use the ball wisely. And it's another good pick from Ardie Savea.
It is advantage.
Another penalty advantage as France transgress.
It is a penalty.
The communication is clear. Tupaia wanting to wriggle his way through. He's so close. Tackle from Ntamack. Ioane loiters to the left. Penaud will have to make the hit. Kane has got out the blocks a bit too early. They go wider and New Zealand have the score. Jordy Barrett smuggles his way over in the corner. And the visitors finally get their first try on the board.
And New Zealand back in the game. Silencing this crowd in Stade de France is what we've been waiting for, a reaction. Straight through Damien Penaud, poor by the winger. But the All Blacks just showing again, when they want to, they can roll their sleeves up.
Have a chat with them behind the
quality type play, pick and go, straight through the heart of this French defence, time after time.
Okay.
25 metres,
right,
ground
thanks,
up, get this bounce too much in the end.
Damien Penaud.
Particularly if
six
they're going to go more direct,
this year,
mate,
twice as many as anybody else, but he has to be one of the Achilles heel areas in terms of French defence. He was found out there, and Barrett has the chance to increase his personal tally. Well, the reaction tells you all you need to know. But it's France 21, Jordy Barrett, and New Zealand 11.
One, three, and two.
Weenie Antonio's work is done. And it doesn't get any easier for New Zealand. It's the big shape of the Leon prop. Demba Bamba comes on, was great in the loose last week, sitting down Georgians for fun in Bordeaux.
Okay, watch on.
Paul Willemse also makes way. There's Romain Taofifenois. Comes onto the field. Changes starting to be made then. Smith. Not going to have that all his own way. Own way is. Aldrich tries to come straight through the middle. Sonny Takayo is onto the field as well for New Zealand.
Ask. Demande.
Movaka. Going a little early.
Movaka was in his rights there. I did not think that the replacement hooker, Tokayaho, was bound.
Zero.
He was in his rights to come around the corner and challenge for that ball.
Zero, replaceable. Yes. Just stand in front of him, mate.
More changes. We are getting to the point where almost.
Yeah.
We almost have two entirely new front rows. Jean-Baptiste Groot. Baptiste Groot is onto the field. Ofatunga Farsi is on as well. Movaka may be the only one still remaining from the start. Penalty France.
Tackle again, launch not quite going to plan. The low chop tackle by Anthony Jalon. We'll see the replay. And again, the physicality by the big Toulouse man. Stops the AB's attacks in its tracks.
Confirmation on screen of the changes. As we see George Bauer help the Crusaders to three Super Rugby titles, last featured against Italy.
Again, the quality of collision forcing the replacement hooker back, allowing the contest. Almost impossible for the All Blacks cleaners to get there.
Line out as one by Aldridge.
How you going, Asa? The premier for what?
Referee gets rid of white lock. It's broken up. Where's
it's
the ball?
Available. No.
Dupont. Danty. Wants to try and wrestle his way through. Almost did as well. Dupont needs to be careful here. Keeps getting down to get his hands on the ball. The referee, he knows, is now going to call it out. And in that scenario, he took too long again, and New Zealand are away. And it's a lovely show from Ioane, and Ioane will break
and get over the line for New Zealand. Second. France can't afford to nap when New Zealand can strike back like that.
Quick as a flash. Turnover ball, we talked about it at the top of the programme. Sam Whitelock with the contest.
Line out his hands on the ball.
Aaron Smith, quick hands. Riku Iwani shows the ball, gets around Cameron Waki, who is rapid for a big second rower. But again, there is no pace compared to that. Riku Iwani, so quick once he gets ball in hand. Ball in two hands, shows the ball. Gavin Villiers sold down the blind side. And quick as a flash, New Zealand back in this game.
Hands are on, the ball's out. And it's a bit of a lift.
Jordy Barrett makes it 12 unanswered points from New Zealand. At the start of this second half, beautiful from Ioane. Held his channel and straightened so well.
What a momentum swing. Two quick tries, New Zealand back in this game.
France 24, New Zealand 18. The French public get the crowd going. Ooh. Ball is tapped back for Bamba. Dupont launches it for Ntamack. Tries to step in on the weaker shoulder of Tunga Fasi, but the replacement prop did really well. Bamba Bamba. Another wrestle to maintain possession. And Aldrich breaks. Oh, it's been wrestled off him from Aaron Smith. Oh, he's just had to deliver it to the French captain, his opposite number. Dupont. Tungo Farsi getting himself in the way. Jalon, accompanied by Danty. Back to the right. There was a moment in the first half, I said France looked like they were just losing structure, and then they were able to produce a score. Are they going to do it again? Penaud, back in for Villiers. Jaminet is there to try and help. Havili is on the floor, but referee Wayne Barnes has spotted a penalty. The French fans are not enjoying what they're seeing from the moment the whistle is blown.
Greg Aldrich just steps in. Antoine Dupont, they grew up together. You don't touch my mate, you don't touch our scrum half.
Wayne Barnes is just going to have a quick chat with Luke Pearce. But it says something about the belief in this French side from the fans that they've turned up the volume after that concession of 12 points. So often, French supporters would start to opt out, start to whistle, start to put the pressure on their own side for conceding.
Six. Wait.
But this is where Fabien Galthié and Raphael Ibanez and Sean Edwards have this French team relative to the French public now.
Greg, pass on Paul, no more, OK? OK, the penalty, Paul, Placard, pass on to you. The penalty is for the player not rolling away. That's a first. I will in a moment.
So Wayne Barnes encourages everyone to put their handbags away. It is a penalty.
Yeah, of course, mate.
And Jaminet,
I got taken out of here. Obstruction.
We'll look to put some more points on the French side of the scoreboard.
Okay, that's my decision.
His
I've already played the ball
before half time.
Work right now, yeah, everyone.
Melvin Jaminet. Four out of four. Thirty-six points so far in the Autumn Nations series. Make that 38. France up to 26. New Zealand 18. 27. My apologies.
Same again.
Well, it's the sort of night I can't even do basic maths, Johnny Beattie. France 27, New Zealand 18. Restart comes down for Ntamack.
Annette.
Barrett. Mwanga inside. Barrett starting to run cross-field rather than giving the pass. Mwanga.
Stop Aaron, yep.
Looking for the high cross-field kick. Dante couldn't hold it.
On avant.
It had come forwards already.
No. On avant, knock on.
DuPont.
Advantage over.
Advantage called over. Mwanga. Oh, New Zealand work in such tight spaces so well. Knocking the ball through to Ardie Sevea. Penalty advantage now. Smith hunted down by Mwaka. Bridge. Bomba was over the top to try and wrestle it away. Smith again. Scragged by his opposite number.
That's the contest we've all wanted to see.
Yeah. Kicked away. Ntamack will field, but we get a sense that Wayne Barnes indeed was going to take that back. Fascinating moment in the game, just a couple of minutes away from the hour. France managing to get 3 points back on the board. But it doesn't seem to have stemmed the slowly growing New Zealand belief through the second half.
Quality work again.
Yes.
A little bit of a block, but once these fellas get ball in hand. Such quality.
Down from Akira Ioane.
Advantage.
Another penalty advantage. France have got to be careful of their discipline now, particularly in this area of the field as New Zealand start to build once more into the 22. The All Blacks with their tails up, Sevea continuing to carry. And then Tunga Fasi lending his weight alongside Takaya. They're coming back.
Offside and entry.
Offside and entry.
You can hear referee Barnes saying there were a couple of penalties to choose from there. The offside.
Look at it. Offside and entry.
Ball coming in at the side.
Il y a beaucoup de penalty, Montenon. Il y a beaucoup de penalty.
Quality work again up front by New Zealand. Staying away from that blitz in the middle of the field, taking France on up front. Earning the way forward up this field.
Two.
Started from a great line-out drive. Taken at the back of the line-out, so hard to defend them all from that position. The damage was done.
Gaetan Barlow. His first Autumn Nations Series appearance.
Wait 10,
as Mwaka makes way. Another two tries under his belt. He's had a great 3 weeks. Down from Retallick. France get a good shove around the corner, but it's still going to be there. New Zealand breaking. 4 metres out, driving low and trying to get over the line. The try is scored. New Zealand fighting their way right back through the second half. And the belief just continuing to grow.
The quality in contact, the quality in power. Again, the first wave really well repelled by France. But the carry, the first carry off the back by Samani Takao. And this one by Ardie Sevea. Again, the quality of Weld and Latch. One of the areas we've seen a lot in the second half of the All Blacks. Ball carrier helped by a man on his backside. 220 kilos against one defender, ploughing through the tackle area.
Well, the rate of scores from either side over the course of this match suggests there are plenty more twists and turns to come. Aaron Smith's night is done. Geordie Barrett. to close the gap to two. Fulier was absolutely out of the traps after that one, but it won't affect the result. Jordy Barrett with 15 points, New Zealand up to 25. France still with their noses in front.
Great. Un second, s'il vous plaît, replacement pour bleu. Wait. Come to vote.
Entamac.
It's a big change as well. Greg Aldrich coming off the field, who's been phenomenal in defence and over the ball. With Thibaut Flamand, completely different type of player, much more aerial.
Pernod absolutely launched himself
and use it!
Play his part in getting that restart as Brad Weber plays his first role.
Use your foot, use your foot.
Three tries from France in the first half. Three tries from New Zealand in the second. We hope you didn't have anywhere to be. Oh, my goodness. Shannon Frizzell is the on as well. Dante! It was a deliberate overthrow to try and find the inside centre, but he couldn't hold it. And now here come the All Blacks, hoping to do what the All Blacks do. Superb chop tackle from Jalon. But they've still got it. And away from Yarani. And good. Barrett with the kick downfield. Mwanga giving chase, as is Weber. Dupont looking to cover. And Tamak in his own goal area. Where's he going? And Tamak, he's screaming up the 22. On the reverse ball for Jaminet. Dupont on the shoulder. France get up to the 22. Villiers. Play back infield from Barlow. France with the adventure to go to the right. Cameron Wauke. Dante waits outside. Wauke straightening and 7 metres out.
Advantage.
Tau Fifenwa plays scrum half. New Zealand back defending on their line once more. The French won this fourth try more than anything. And now we have a penalty. And one of the All Blacks will go to the bin. Well, Ardy Savea is going to be the man given his marching orders. Ultimately a professional foul, slowing France down right when they had their tails up.
What about that for a phase of play, Nick? Unbelievable stuff.
End to end, isn't
the
it?
The daring from behind their own goal line, Romain Ntamack. Again, the belief, the ability with the fend, the pace to get outside Jordy Barrett. And what about this for a no-look pass to Melvin Jaminet? We've just missed it.
That was stunning, wasn't it?
Absolutely beautiful, the quality of play, and again the vision then to distribute, not to panic, straightened up by Cameron Wauke. The ball could have gone, but again the option at three. But what a piece of play by this French side.
Jaminet will take 3 points to reward the ambition. France up to 30. New Zealand 25. Moments of mesmeric brilliance from France. For a moment in that attack, I could swear Serge Blanco was still out there.
Exactly.
Five-point game. Mwanga. Ntamack doesn't mess around.
Couloir, merci.
Bakayo Chiefsuka. Some are calling the find of the season. They go to the tail. Down through Weber. Mwonga. David Havili onto the field and still not successfully held, and he's really putting in a shift since he's come on. Does well to maintain the possession. And there's a good carry from Shannon Frizzell. Sitting down a couple of the French defenders. Mwonga. This is the period of the game where France are going to really have to dig deep. Retallick and the All Blacks, a team who know how to win big test matches, know how to keep grinding through. And Tamak, one of those, trying to help the forwards effort and hold it up. Barrett slips it to Havili, who tries to get it away. Carl Dixon confirming that the ball went back, but now Mwonga, as he tried to find an option, was tracked down by Woki. New Zealand going off their feet to try and secure the ball. Taofi Fenwa comes up. The French public loving what they're seeing defensively from France.
And it has been strange watching this All Black side. Every time they get to the edge in attack, they look a little bit frantic, a little bit panicked, under constant pressure by the French counterparts. And once the ball comes into the middle of the field, panic support, he gets Topé up, goes off his feet, another penalty under French pressure.
Cameron Wokey's worked his socks off over the course of the game. But now, fascinating change as far as the French momentum is going. Romain Antemac will be replaced by another maestro. Mathieu Jalibert, the Bordeaux bag to fly half. Man with the most line breaks in the top 14 comes off. We've seen the Jali and Tamak partnership over the course of the first couple of weeks of the Autumn Nations series. Galtier deciding to going back to the tried and tested the method with a single fly half in the 10 roll. To allow Danti onto the field, who pops up as first receiver there.
Oh,
the intercept for Penaud! Penaud is going to go under the post for France, and the Stade de France is absolutely enraptured with the winger. Make that seven tries in 2021, but that interception might just be the home fans' favourite.
What a moment, well read again by Damien Penaud. Saves the overlap, they're under real pressure. Jumps out the line, plucks the ball out there. Look what it means to him and to this French crowd.
Penaud, they scream. Melvin Jaminet. Going to take as long over this as he is legally allowed to do.
You've got 90 seconds. You've got about 20 seconds.
30 seconds, says Wayne Barnes. Jaminet will need to get onto this if he wants those
extra 2 points.
He has 90
seconds to kick the ball.
France reopen a 12-point lead. They lead New Zealand 37 points to 25. With 11 minutes left in Paris.
And again, even from turnover play, we spoke about it in the first half, the ability of this French defensive line to rush, to blitz, put you under pressure, it's caused absolute havoc.
Four tries now for France as Jaminet sends that down towards Rico Ioane. Gets past Retallick, who then arrives and gives the support. Weber back for Mwonga, thinks about the crossfield effort. Penaud has to track back and will get his hands on it. Offloaded beautifully. Jaminet dumped on his backside. It's still French ball. Woki. He's done so much tonight. Woki, I almost thought he was shaping for a crossfield kick for a second. Dupont. Barrett. New Zealand having to operate in this cauldron of an atmosphere as La Marseillaise rings around once again.
I passed.
Ioane. Always able to create something. Leg drives right into the tackle. The pick. Strength from Taukayo. Havili. Barrett on the outside. Havili. Oh, that's really good strength from the replacement. Fiku was having to work hard, having been denied the opportunity to make the tackle the first time. Now it's there for Weber once more. Moonga misses Kane. Did that go forwards? There was a knock-on. It will be a France scrum.
One stop, please.
Rico Ioane.
One stop. Richie.
Again, taking the ball. One-on-one efforts to the gain line, breaking tackles. Just again, a little bit frantic, not able to settle, not into their systems. Struggling a little bit for
first
rhythm.
Scrum, just loads of balance. Okay.
Ball comes out.
First scrum,
uncharacteristic
loads of balance.
Error. Unforced error in the back line.
Richie Mwanga makes way. Damien McKenzie.
Just come up a little bit, please.
Comes onto the field to earn his 40th cap. Chiefs man. Just at the end of half time, McKenzie seemed to be the one leading the chat amongst the replacements.
Beaucoup de balance. Restez en haut. Loads of balance, good height.
Of course, missed Rugby World Cup 2019 after an ACL injury. Antoine Dupont.
Crouch.
Nominated World Rugby Player of the Year with Maro Itoje. Aussie, Australia's
just get that balance,
Michael Hooper.
Get that balance.
Samu Karevi.
Wait. Little bit.
Sam Whitelock watches on. His evening complete.
Balance.
The Black Ferns played their last tour match earlier today in Cast, beaten 29-7. It's been a torrid tour for the Black Ferns, but they have blooded 14 new caps.
Okay. A little higher, restez en haut. A little higher, restez en haut.
Can't think of a day when the Black Ferns and the All Blacks could both walk away from France having suffered defeat.
And pertinently, we saw the faces of Samuel Whitelock, we saw Dane Coles.
Good height, rest
there have to be some questions asked, even if they come on to win this game, just of the performance in general. They have never lost in this stadium.
Set.
The two performances now, they're unlike them, not at their standards.
Dupont, Dante was the dummy runner. Jalibert is screaming at the heart of the New Zealand defence, and it's Jaminé who then pops up for Jalibert. Oh. The ball thrown inside didn't go to hand. McKenzie's got to try and tidy it up for the All Blacks.
Pass,
scintillating from the French back line. Weber, Barrett, not got a great clearance on that.
Passes forward.
It was a forward pass at the end, which will allow New Zealand another scrum and a chance to make a more settled clearance.
Watch his stop. Watch his stop.
What a starter play again by France. Switching play around the back of that scrum. The All Blacks forced retreat. Scramble D. Melvin Jammeh again. He's shown his pace time and time again. Quality piece of play. Manages to get that first pass away to Jalibert. The next one's a little bit forced. But again, what a phase of play by France.
Same height.
Well thought out, executed properly.
Same
height. New Zealand under the cosh.
The All Blacks pack back up to full strength. The surveyor comes on to rejoin. Dylan Cretin makes his first alternation series appearance on for Cameron Woki.
The French pack get a really big shove on here. Where's the ball? It's there right on the line. And France going to reload.
Scrum five.
They'll reload at the scrum. New Zealand having to take it over. But what a shove from the French pack.
Incredible, absolutely incredible. You can see again the passion roaming into Mac.
Sorry, mate.
How much that means to him as a 10. You can see the work of Demba Bamba.
It was fine for me.
The hustle again by that man, Antoine Dupont.
Okay, good height.
It's just been incessant all evening. Blue jerseys scrambling. White jerseys flying backwards.
The fans want more.
Crouch! Bind! Set! Reculé behind the ball.
France have to use it. It's popped up for Dupont. He's having a look down the short side, but he might think better of it. Decides to just straighten. Wrestles himself away from the second tackle. He's almost a one-man team as he goes into Havili. Then it's away for Barlow. Barlow, well driven back by Tonga Fasi, who says, not in my house.
If you like, so right up.
Thibaut Flamand puts his body on to help, but it's coming back on New Zealand's side. It's there for Brad Webber. Looks over to the right. New Zealand have got a long way to go from here, trailing by 12 points. McKenzie. Is that going to go into touch? No. Jaminet catches it above his head. Considers coming back down the short side. Gavin Villiers was there. Knew he had to provide the support at the ruck. Flamand. Dupont. Jalibert. Across the face. Jolon. Danty over the top. Penaud decides the little chip might work. Over McKenzie. McKenzie brought over his own goal line once again. It's going to be another 5 metre scrum to France. And all the while, the clock continues to tick down.
What stops? Okay. Are we coming?
Lovely piece of play. Sleight of hand by Anthony Jolon to keep the ball alive. The miss pass by Jonathan Danty and the chip over the top again by Damien Penaud. Follows up his own kick again into the 22, forcing New Zealand back. And another 5 metre scrum for France.
Anton, red placing. Wait. Yeah. The last scrum, good height, went forward. Perfect, thank you. Last scrum, good height, knees off the floor going forward.
Are France about to make quite a bit of history? Stade de France is on its feet. The tricolours are waving. They applaud Antoine Dupont. He is the man that represents so much about this French side.
Yeah, you got it.
Epitomised by his last carry as well. I mean, shrugging forwards off, bumping people, stepping, never giving up. And now the calm, the cool,
balance.
He exudes as captain.
Beaucoup de balance.
An inspiration for the French rugby Watch public. On. They absolutely
Crouch.
Adore him.
Maxime Lecoux earns his second cap. He's on the bench against Argentina. Played against Georgia last week. Lecoux. Wanted to go in and get the ball, but it's Jolon who decided to come away with it.
Let go! Let go!
New Zealand, since they might need a few numbers on that short side, Taofi Fenua has Bamba.
No free line.
He was well met by Tonga Fasi. A try here from France would seal the deal. Lecoux. It's up for Gros. France continue to come round the corner, there for Dylan Cretin. the man credited with being the impetus behind so many of France's backs moves, Gaël Ficou. Bamba was almost allowed a second bite at the cherry. Lecou, Cretin once more. Now they put some width on it, but Jalibert decides the best thing to do is come back inside. He was guilty of a second movement.
OK, I'm just going to move and turn and you're good to go.
And Francois Croix just trying to slow it down, has conceded another 10 metres. Less than 3 minutes to go, 12 points the difference. New Zealand will have a line out close to France, close to the French half.
S'il vous plaît, s'il vous plaît.
A last shot for New Zealand to generate something positive in this game. Realistically now finish this season on a high.
It's down and off the top from Tupouvai. Going straight up the middle is Frizzell. Havili's carried really well when he's been on as well. Playing link man just a moment ago. Oh, it's a superb bit of work from Dylan Cretin. Justifying Galtier's call to go with a 6-2 split on the bench as well. A key turnover at a key time.
We talked before the game. Areas required for progression from New Zealand from last week. Physicality, breakdown.
And
they have been bested in both areas. Titanic effort by France.
Last meeting between the sides, it was a 3-0 win to the All Blacks
outside
on France's 2018 summer tour.
Pull them a bit more backside, just in case they take it against their head.
New Zealand have only suffered back-to-back defeats once since the end of 2011. It was November last year, losing against Australia and Argentina in what was that Tri-Nations competition without South Africa. After this curious year or two we've had. Final minute then. Galtier and Ibanez watch on. France look to roll it round the front through Flamand. France having to show composure as much as adventure as they mature. Bamba, Villiers wanting to put the pressure on. It's another penalty to France. The arms are aloft already from Anthony Jalon, and the French players start to believe.
There's still players around the ball.
We're into the final minute, and the penalty award will mean it's a matter of moments for Jaminet to have a shot at goal and seal an historic victory.
Thank you. That's a sample of the penalty.
Well, it would be fitting for Jaminet. 17 points already. He makes it 20. He makes it 40 for France. It's been scintillating, inspirational, sensationnel. It's a first win against the All Blacks in Paris since 1973. And perhaps it's also the kind of consistency that has the French public taking more and more notice of Fabien Galtier and his men. The road to a home World Cup in 2023 starts here. It'll be a repeat of this fixture to kick off that particular big dance. And the French have just taken a big step towards it. Movaka crowned man of the match for his double try scoring efforts. But it finishes at the Stade de France. France 40, New Zealand 25.